So I think India is also catching up, and Mazagon Dockyard has acquired credible expertise now in construction of submarines. So what do you think are the components that are being imported for the production of these submarines? And by what time can we manufacture a fully indigenous submarine, including the weaponry associated with the same?
See, Mazagon Dock is doing a great job at the moment. They're building the Project 75 Scorpion class submarines. However, unfortunately, and this is something that, naval planners must understand and keep in mind, the Indian submarine, progressive indigenous submarine construction has been very haphazard in India. We built two submarines in the early 90s, in 1992 and 94, INS Shalky and INS Shankul, which are still sailing. After that, because of political reasons, this program was terminated. Those boats were also built in Mazagon Docks. Now, no nation can afford the luxury of creating a submarine building capability, putting in that kind of investment, and then shutting it down after two submarines. So from 1992, we did nothing till 2005 when we signed a contract with a naval group of France to build the Scorpion class. So literally speaking, we had to start all over again in trying to build submarines by ourselves. Now, the Scorpion class does not have very much of indigenous content, frankly speaking. If you take indigenous content in the Navy, we look at three elements of a ship, and we can apply the same analogy to a submarine. It's float, move, and fight. So the float element is the part of the ship which is required to keep to make the ship float in water, which fundamentally means the hull of the ship. So far, the steel that is being used for submarines being built in India is not Indian. It's imported because it's a special grade steel. But And this is very important, but the nuclear submarine Arihant, which has been also built in India, which I will tell you more about later, the steel for that has been built in India. And it has very clearly been articulated that any new submarine that is built in India from now onwards, after the Scorpion program is over, will be built with Indian steel. So the moment you have Indian steel, your float element straight away, you have 90% indigenous content because the float element is mainly about the hull and the steel and other materials that are being used for building the ship to keep it floating. Then you have a move element. The move element is about engines, diesel generators, motors, the things which make a ship move, pumps, systems, pipelines, etc. Now, in this, India is making some progress. Most of the valves, the pipelines, some of the systems, the electronics, a lot of it is being done in India. But important things like the main motor of the submarine, which makes the submarine move, the diesel generators which charge the batteries to make the motor move, all these are still imported. But as we go along and we start building submarines on a sort of a production line basis, unfortunately, so far it's been bits and pieces. You build two, now you're building six, then you'll build another six. So it doesn't make sense for industry to make that investment if all you're going to do is buy two diesel engines from them or four diesel engines from them. But the moment this becomes a chain production, a production line is set up, which keeps churning out submarines one every year or one every 2 years, then automatically the industrial capability will build. Insofar as the weapon element is concerned, which you referred to, that we call the fight element. At the moment, most of the submarine weapons that we have are imported. But let me also tell you, notwithstanding that, most of these weapons, that's the missiles and the torpedoes, submarine main weapons are torpedoes and missiles. The torpedoes and missiles are all at an advanced stage of development happening right now with the DRDO. So we hope that by the time the next class of submarine is built, whichever is the next class, let's say Project 75I, that would be equipped with Indian sonars, Indian radars, Indian torpedoes, Indian missiles. The BrahMos missile is being developed for a submarine application. So work is happening in all these areas. These are very high technology things. This technology doesn't come overnight. It takes time to build. Nobody shares this kind of technology with you from abroad, so you have to do it yourself. And so it's work in progress. And I'm very confident that another 8 to 10 years, by the time the next class of submarine starts getting built, a lot of that submarine will be Indian and indigenous and not so much imported.